Now you are audible and visible as well.
What? Why? How come your second hand is free? Why isn't it this pose? What happened? Where have you like put your phone?
Actually, I'm using tripod, a small tripod.
Oh, fancy people. They have a tripod now. I have my phone attached to a table. The laptop table thing. And we have fancy people here. They have tripods. Okay. When did you start using a tripod?
Actually, I purchased it, say, 2-3 months back. But I didn't use it. I kept it in a certain place and I did not use it. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I told about Romil, you know, one tutor.
Yeah.
So she always asks me, why are not using that one? Every time I had a class.
Okay, so she taunted you.
Yeah, so every time when I had a class with her, she would ask me, why are you not using? Yeah. So ultimately, I had to use it. So I'm using it now.
Good. At least she is not letting your money get wasted. You know, she's like, you put money in the tripod. No, use it for doing this only.
Yeah. One day she told me that if you are not using, you can send me to my address.
I'll use the tripod. You are just wasting the money and the tripod.
When yeah. She told me that you can send it to me if you are not using, from the next very class I am started using it.
He's like, no, I will use it, but I will not send it to you. Okay, that's good. But anyway, how are you?
I am doing great. I am well. What about you? You seem to be in a very good mood. Yeah.
Don't I always?
Don't look like a tired person today.
On other days, I look tired?
A little bit. I mean, after joining your duty. So, did you have duty today?
Yes, of course. I don't think. Today was like my 12th day without an off, working straight.
Oh my God.
Without an off, yeah.
Without any break.
Without any break. No week off. I even went on Sunday. It was tiring.
So when you get back home?
Sometimes it's 6:30, sometimes 7. Today I got back at 7:50. So yeah, it's not fixed.
7:50?
7:50, yeah.
Oh my God. So it's...
It's a bit
only 2 hours.
Erratic. Yes.
Yeah.
Not even 2 hours. 8 to 9. That's it. 9 to 10, 10 to 11, I take sessions.
Okay.
That's the routine. But yeah, it's fun. It is.
But you are not using your title, which is a doctor. Still you are not using.
I should put it as Dr. Parveen here. It's like, you know, I let me just get my degree first. Once I get my degree, I'll officially change my name to doctor. Then it would look cooler. Right now, just an intern, no?
Okay.
That's the problem. So yeah, let's see if this finishes off. We've got the degree. The degree also we'll get like in November 2022.
1 year. More year.
Because the convocation takes place at around October, November.
But before that, you can't use it. I think you can use it, isn't it?
We can. We can go for provisional degree we do get so that you can apply for masters. You can apply for job. You can apply for stuff. You can. But the official degree with... everything mentioned, you get this on convocation.
Okay.
But at this time, let's see when it happens. Or if it's going to happen at all, like online, offline stuff still goes, then I'm okay with offline convocation, online convocation. I want to see people's faces. Yeah, they've become a nightmare kind of a thing. But yeah.
So How you are finding it? Your work so with the patients.
Oh, it's fun. It's so much
fun.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Because you know you feel good that you stay busy all day, you do stuff. And currently these days I'm in rehab. So rehab means everything in the OPD is manual. You do with your hands. No machine, no nothing. In the first month I was on rounds that I used to go to wards, ICUs, etc. Then I went into machines. And now I'm into exercises, like actually dealing with paralysis patients who cannot walk, who cannot do stuff on their own. So you deal with them directly. So it feels like you have so much power in your hands. So it feels good that you stay so busy. At the end of the day, we are like four interns in rehab and we are like lying on top of each other. We're like, okay, that's enough. That's actually enough. But it's super fun. Yeah. Because, you know, in rehab, there are a lot of things you need to take care of. And you need to take care of the patient alone. You can have help, of course you can. But your main aim should be do not let the patient fall. No matter how disbalanced, how hard it is to make him stand or make him walk, he should not fall. Because, you know, things get ugly if a person falls.
Yes.
Because there'll be other injuries, other trauma, and there is psychological trauma that I fell, I couldn't walk. So this is like the main rule. Never let your patient fall. And me being a girl, I have like more pressure because I am like a weak kid. It takes a lot of energy for me to lift patients on my own. It's very hard. So I try my level best to, you know.
Most of the time you are alone with the patient or there is some assistance also that...
If I'm taking the exercise part, then I'm alone. If I have to make the patient stand up or walk, then I take help. Because when a patient is paralyzed, he becomes heavier.
Yes, yes.
Much more heavier because
control
over his body. And I'm a tiny person. How will I hold him? There was one guy and he was paralyzed from one side and he was like 6 feet with a good height and a good weight. And I was like, I was here, you know. I'm like, if I have to make him stand, how will I do it? So I took four people with me. Like, I cannot do this alone, obviously. You have to be smart here. You don't have to be like, prove yourself. No. Your aim is that you need to treat the patient.
Yes.
So I take four people's help. I'm like, aap yaha khade raho, aap yaha, aap yaha. So I guide those people. So yeah, it's
And is it necessary that one person from the patient side should be there while you are
treating? Yes. Patient's attendant, yeah. One attendant has to be there. But that is up to the attendant if he wants to stay with the patient. Some people leave their patient in the OPD and they go.
Okay.
So it's up to the patient. Sorry, up to the attendant. Not a compulsion, but yeah, in the rooms, when we go to the wards, an attendant always has to be there. If there's no attendant, then we won't start.
Okay.
That's the deal. In rehab, when you come to the OPD, that's not the case. Yeah. It's like, you know, you are taking information because you are joining from tomorrow. Oh, God. But yeah, it's super fun. But it's like, you know, 4 months are already over. And I cannot even believe that 4 months are done. Just two more months to go.
Okay, so time flies so fast.
So fast. And I think these 4 months have been the best ever. I did not enjoy this much in college. The way I've enjoyed it here in the hospital. Learned a lot of things. Made a good image. That's what don't know what's going to happen further.
Yeah, you are doing a very great job, and you can, your effort will put a smile on the face
Yeah.
of on the face of the patients. Yeah. So
Exactly.
when you will get to see that, it'll automatically give a good
Exactly.
feeling.
Exactly.
Yes.
Well, I do, you know, it's the best thing is that I get positive feedbacks, such word, and that's the highlight of the day. That at least you did your work with an effort that, you know, makes the patient happy. The first thing is that you need to get the patient to smile. Because when they are paralyzed, they don't have control over their body, they are traumatized. They feel like a burden, that I'm a burden on my family. I cannot clean my own stuff, my own thing. I cannot stand on my own 2 feet. So it's a mental trauma.
Yes.
But some people are very positive, even though that person's both hands and legs don't work. But he will always keep smiling, making jokes, and he always cooperates with his exercise. He knows, he puts in effort, like, okay, let's try this so that my hand lifts from this to this. So it's fun. It's good to watch them. So you get all sorts of people, all sorts of people.
And negative persons also, who thinks that, no, I am not going
to
get well.
Once I
this
went,
is the end of the world, like that.
Exactly.
The feeling is
she
like that.
She started crying, even though she was walking, but she was crying like so bad. And I'm like, why are you crying? She's like, I used to be so active. I used to be so beautiful. And now I'm not. I'm like, what are you saying? You actually walked outside with so many stitches and all. You actually walked. And you're saying that you are not beautiful or you're not active. So that becomes a difficult situation. You need to counsel them in a way that they manage stuff together.
So it is difficult to deal with the, those kind of patients than the positive ones. A little bit.
Of course it is. A little bit, yeah.
Yeah.
Because I wouldn't feel good to leave the patient while she's crying. Even though my
yeah,
part was
yeah.
done. My part was done. I had done what I had to do. My therapy and all. And after that, she started crying. So it's not like, oh, I'm done. I should just go let her cry. No, I cannot do that. I sat with her for another 15, 20 minutes. Stopped her from crying. Calmed her down. Like, it's okay. Life throws all sorts of problems at you. You have to, like, you know, kick them back. So
it's not only the physical therapy, but also the counseling also matters. You have to counsel the person.
Counsel the person is very important. Very important.
Yeah. Yes, yes.
Because, you know, I have a very strong belief in the fact that you heal from your body later. You heal from your mind first.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Yes.
If you'll think positive, you'll be positive. If you've made this notion that I can never get better, this is end of the world, like you mentioned, then I'm sorry, your body is not going to, you know, cooperate with you. So first,
and most of the time, it depends on the doctors, so how they behave with the patients and how they counsel with them. Actually, I have had an experience for of such kind of thing, because once I felt like depression kinds of thing. So I had to consult once psychiatrist, actually.
Okay.
And I tried with several doctors, but it didn't help me. Even I had to take sleeping pills, but it did not cure me. And the problem was there. Then I met one doctor. And the moment I talked with him, the doctor asked me some questions, and the way he behaved with me, I felt that 50% of my problem sorted out.
Wow.
I felt that immediately.
Mm-hmm.
And this is, then I thought that, yeah, it depends so many things. I mean,
a lot of factors.
Yeah, depends on the doctors also, how they behave and how they talk with the patients.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it matters.
So any reason for your depression?
I don't know what happened. You know, it was way back in 2010. So I could not sleep for so many days, so many things came up to my mind. All the things were negative things that came to my mind.
Okay.
Whatever I used to see, I think that, oh, it's not going to last forever. It will be destroyed. Like there's so many negative things came to my mind.
Yeah.
And I did not get any, I mean, not even for 5 minutes, I did not get any sleep. So I had to pass so many days, even months. I was thinking like that, I'm going to be mad. So my luck was, I got some information from some of my known persons that there is a doctor. If you consult, it will help you. Then the doctor, his chamber was 500 kilometers away from my city. So I met him. And yeah, it helped me a lot. The moment I talked to him,
I felt
50% of my problem was solved. And I took some medicines also. So it helped me. And gradually I
got better.
Got over my problem, yeah.
Great.
I never thought that I would come out of this problem. It was so severe, actually.
Yeah. Okay. But I'm happy you're out of it.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. I'm happy you're out of it. Because
if I was not out of it, so I would never be able to meet Dr. Parveen Khan.
You wouldn't have been able to meet the fun, cheerful, full of life, yeah. Mr. Subhash Paul. That would have been like never, never, ever written in my life. That's good. But yeah, it's like, you know, once in a lifetime, there is a phase which feels like so long and never ending. It becomes like a vicious cycle thing that you'll never get
out of. Yeah, yeah. I never thought that I would come to this stage now that I'm in. I thought that it is already...
End of the world.
What happened. Yes, yes.
Yeah. But that's true. See, I always have one notion that you have to stay positive no matter what. No matter what. So I go with this thinking... that I stay positive. And okay, yeah. Even if it's a life-threatening situation, I'll be like, no, you'll find a solution that you'll get out of it. Even though there's like nothing you can do about it. So I'm like, okay, if you cannot do anything about it, then why cry? You can smile and go ahead because anyway, you won't be able to do anything. So why that extra pressure?
Yes, that's what. Actually, now I have learned to deal with all these things. So if sometimes negative thought comes to my mind, I try to distract it and I think positively. Mm. Okay, so the things that are happening is not in my control.
In your control.
So I don't have anything to do. So I'll have to accept it and go with the flow. This is how I deal with the situation that comes to me, my life here. And it helps, actually.
That is true. Mm. Ultimately, everything... Also, you know, I believe that everything happens for a reason.
Mm-hmm.
Everything happens for a reason.
Mm-hmm.
If right now you feel like, oh, what good is this thing going to get me? Why is this happening to me? At some point of time, you will feel like, okay, this thing happened for a specific reason. And this was the thing that it targeted. So all you need to do is be positive and have patience.
Yeah, patience.
That I've
yes.
learned from life. Be patient and be positive. That's all.
Yes,
what
yes,
has
right.
to happen will happen. You don't have control over those things. So why cry over things you don't have control over? So it's
yes, right.
Forget about it. But yeah, it's good. Cannot say the best, but yeah. It's how life works. But who am I to tell? You know better. You know better.
No. You are also a doctor. You have got some knowledge about it. Yes, you can tell me. No problem. So, what
But
about your winter season in Delhi? So, I think still
it's
it is
very
going
bad.
well. You are
It's
waiting
very
for the worst
bad.
to
It's
come.
very bad. It's like, oh shit, it's just November. There's December also. There's January also. How will I survive? I'm more worried about this thing. I'm like, I cannot handle this, please God. Don't make it any more below the belt temperature, because it is like not in my favor. I hate winters. Hate winters. And you know what? I'm going to Uttarakhand next week for a family function. Like in the month of November, I'm going to Uttarakhand. My family is crazy. Crazy. Like, why? Who goes to Uttarakhand in the month of November? It's going to be so cold. Oh God. I'm in mental trauma right now. How will I deal with those 4 days? I don't want to. I just hope everything goes well.
It'll go well. Don't
I hope
worry.
so. I hope so. I've asked my mom to like keep all my jackets. Keep all my jackets. Keep all my jackets, keep all the sweaters, everything. Oh God, it's going to be crazy.
What is the place it is called in Uttarakhand that you are going to visit?
In Uttarakhand, there's a place called Masi.
Masi, okay.
Masi, yeah. And a few, not few, I mean, it's far off. I don't know what that name is. Okay, I forgot. Either it was Chakotia or Chona, one of the two things it was. I'm not very good with names. So, yeah, one of these two things, it's the name. So, at this place, the family is gathering together. And from there, the dulha will go to the bridesmaid.
Oh, well, there is a new, I mean, there is a wedding ceremony that you
Yeah,
are
there's
going
a
to.
wedding. Yeah, there's a
Okay.
wedding. My cousin brother is getting married.
Okay.
I'm like, this was the time you got to get married. I mean, in November, and that too in Uttarakhand. Why? Why? Why do you want
Why
that
it is happening to me?
to happen? Yeah, exactly. I'm telling him like, why do you want to get married? Leave it now. Just say it like, oh, just because you cannot come to Uttarakhand in the month of November, I should not get married. I'm like, yeah, don't get married at all. But unfortunately, he's like, no, I want to get married. I'm like, fine, go ahead, do whatever you want. So Uttarakhand it is. Let's
So
hope.
generally people enjoy when marriage happens in winter. Generally, not I am talking about Parvin
You cannot
Khan.
even wear anything. Girls, being a girl, you have to wear such fancy clothes. It either should be backless, or it either should be like a good dress kind of a thing. You know what I mean? But in winters, how will you do that?
Yeah, you have to
Oh,
cover
I
the
cannot
whole
do
body.
exactly. That's one. And second, I don't like to go to weddings, because at most of the weddings, I'm not saying all, but yeah, in some weddings there is the thing that you have to stand and eat. Yeah, that's another thing that I don't like. I don't like to stand and eat. I don't like to stand in queues to get the food. It's weird. I want a place
Okay.
where I can sit peacefully. No matter what I'm eating, it's okay. But give me a place to sit and eat in peace.
Okay, so you're talking that you are not you don't like the buffet system.
No, I don't like the buffet system. It's very, very. I will like the buffet if there are tables and chairs and you can sit. It's fixed that you will get a place to sit. But you know, perhaps cases that is not.
But in some cases they arrange also. I think that even if you can take the food on your own standing in the queue, then you come back to a table and sit there and take your
Yeah.
food.
My
Yeah.
mom's side, the Pahari families, the thing is that the Pahari family is like gigantic. Gigantic. The number of people is like never ending in Pahari families. You know, so no matter how many tables and chairs The family is
Okay,
going
got
to
it.
arrange. You are not going to get a place. This is
Okay,
also one
I
of the
got it,
reasons
got
I don't like to
it.
go to weddings. I tell my
Even though
mom,
they
please
are
you go. I don't want to go.
okay, got it. That even though there are arrangements, so you are not going to get a place there.
Yeah, exactly. Because what happens in Pahari families is like you cannot leave even a single person because that person might get offended that, oh, they didn't invite us. No. You need to invite each and everyone, even though they're like your distant relations. You have to invite them. So that's the thing.
Sometimes so happen, you know, that I have faced that while attending some marriage ceremony and this party. So the buffet system, people gathered in such large number that even you cannot maneuver your hand. Suppose you have to take your spoon, somebody will come from behind and push you.
God.
It happened also. Happened to me also.
You know, I've even attended like good weddings again where no matter how many people there are, everything is organized. You don't feel that hassle or that weird feeling that, oh God, how many people have gathered? No, but it's kind of a mixed experience. I've attended all sorts.